हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक।
वेलकम वंस अगेन
चिल्ड्रन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी लेसन इंग्लिश ग्रामर लेसन नंबर 19। इंग्लिश ग्रामर लेसन नंबर 19 दैट इज वर्ब्स। वर्ब्स लेसन 19। बिफोर दैट वी विल बिगिन विद अ स्मॉल प्रेयर। चिल्ड्रन जॉइन योर हैंड्स, close your eyes and say the prayer along with the teacher. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Our Father who is in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sin as we forgive those who sin against us, and lead us not into temptation but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Open your eyes children. God bless you all kids. So let's begin with our grammar lesson number 19, verb. A verb is a word that states an action, a fact, or a happening. We do several actions every day. Also things happen around us naturally, apart from the action and the happening. We note certain facts as well as. There are words in every language that are used to express these three things: facts, actions, and happening. Let us study some example. Now children, what is verb? A verb is a word that states action, fact, or happening. Means we do several actions every day. Then things happen around us naturally sometime. Then we notice some facts. Yes, then we will see some examples. Birds are flying in the air. Action. A rose gives a sweet smell. Fact. It rained very heavily yesterday. Happening. The words in these sentences, the word are flying shows us action. They show that the birds do the action of flying. That means we are coming to know that what action they are doing. Birds, what action the birds are doing. So they are flying. Then in the second sentence, the word gives out state the fact about the rose flower. Means it's a fact, a rose gives us sweet smell. A rose gives out sweet smell. Then in the third, rained. It rained very heavily yesterday. That means it happened. What happened yesterday? Rain. So it is happening. Then tense. The word tense points to the period of time in which an action or a happening take place. Time has three main divisions in general. Tense time, present, past and future. Now children, there are main three tense. They are past, present and future. Past tense means before now. Present tense means now. Future tense means after now. Now we will take some example. Past tense, yesterday we visited zoo. Yesterday means it already happened. Now our English lecture is on. So this is present tense. Tomorrow we are going to Bombay.
So, future tense, tomorrow. Yesterday, past tense. Now, today, this is present tense. Future tense, that is tomorrow. Then, not only tomorrow, next month, next week, means whatever is after now, means whatever is going to happen. Most of the verbs have three different forms that are used for various tense. We must learn these forms. Verbs are words that show what the subject does, says, has, or is. Verbs have definite form. All forms of verb come from base verb. A base verb is the simplest form of a verb without any special ending. Now, children, this you will study in detail in higher class. This is just to for a knowledge. A base verb changes form to show tense. Play, present tense. Played, past tense. Will play, future tense. This is play means present tense. Played ed. Played ed is added, so past tense. Will play, will for the future. All action verbs come from the base from form of doing verbs. Grandpa is reading the newspaper. Base is what? Read. Base is what? Read verb. The children were screaming. So, this was some few examples. Now, remember, a verb is an action verb. A verb is an action word. With when an action we come to know with the help of any word, that is verb. There are three main divisions of time, that is present, past and future. Verbs takes different forms in these three divisions of times. Worksheet. Underline the verbs in these sentences. Write them in the blank. Sentence and verb. Children, here you have to underline the verb and write it in the blank. The dog barked at the beggar. Barked. Mother is cooking food for us. Cooking is verb. Suresh will come in the evening. Come. We work during the day. Work. Health is really a great wealth. Is. An earthquake occurred yesterday. Occurred. I learn my lesson well. Learn. Honey tastes very sweet. Tastes. The teacher find the latecomers. Find. She fell down suddenly. Fell. So children, these were some verbs from this sentences. Question B. Write in each blank with the correct form of verb given in the bracket. Your children, some sentences are given and verbs are there. You have to choose from there and make the correct sentence. Form the correct sentence. I shall meet him while going to school tomorrow. The room was in a mess when I got there. From the bracket, you have to choose the correct answer. So second is was. The younger brother rises very early every day. Sometime it rains heavily in July and August. The birds flew away along with their net that day. The birds flew away along with the net that day. Yesterday we learnt our lesson well. Yesterday we learnt our lesson well. Now here match the pair. You have to match the correct pair of these from column A to B. Some questions were very difficult. No one could answer correctly. I want to go to railway station. Will someone give me a lift? There are 25 pupils in the class. Everyone is present. Hari broke the window pane. The teacher will punish him. It is very late. I shall come tomorrow. He is sick. He wants to see a doctor. Question D. Write the past and past participle forms of each verb. Your children, present tense is given. You have to write past tense of that word and past participle. Run, rain, rain. Run, drink, drank, drunk. Write, wrote, written. Begin, began, begun. Agree, agreed, agreed, ed. Sleep, slept, sleep, slept, slept. Gather, gathered, gathered. Eat, ate, eaten. Find, found, found. Shake, shook, shaken. So these were the past tense and past participle. So children, you have to complete your book. We will come back in our next video. Till then, stay home and stay safe. Bye children.